since the news is so serious these days, I decided to sing you something silly that I wrote in 1981-ish and I sang on Johnny Carson in 1983. I turned my pimple into a beauty mark, and no one knows what really goes on beneath the black dot of my face. I'm not a disgrace anymore. I took a thick black pen to the big red zit and darkened it and covered it, and now a beauty mark is all that shows by my nose. You may think it oh so vain to cover all the sins, oh so vain to cover all the sins our bodies bear. But God forbid if one should discover what really hides under our underwear. Okay, I was 20 when I wrote this. I'm happy with my beauty mark now, and I might just keep it in. But I think I feel another pimple starting on my chin, and I can't keep making beauty marks till my face is full of black speckles. That would be worse than pimples. I know, I'll turn them into freckles. Thank you. And now back to serious reality. So I was hearing about the Equality Act all week. Equality, equality, equality. I'm so tired of hearing about equality. Everybody knows that everyone's equal. The Bible says everyone's equal. But I was thinking, you know, we might be born equally loved by God, but we are not born with equal gifts. For instance, I was not born with a beautiful singing voice. My funny Valentine, sweet comic Valentine, you make me smile with my heart. That's the vibrato. Your looks are laughable, unphotographable.
Is your figure less than Greek? Is your mouth a little weak? When you open it to speak, are you smart? Oh, don't change your hair for me. Not if you care.
So, you know, our Constitution says all men are created equal. True. We are equally loved by God. We are not created with equal singing voices. And then, you know, there's the nature nurture, you know. You like my nails? Ooh. $8 press on. But, you know, like how you grow up, like Hillbilly Elegy, which I just watched, you know, it's not what, how you're born. You can't, you have no control over who birthed you or where you were birthed. You only have control over what you do with it. And I am still trying to learn how to sing As Pretty as That Girl on American Idol. My funny Valentine. Jesus loves the little children, all the children of the world. are precious in his sight. Jesus loves the little children of the world. Yeah, so this week I've been hearing a lot about equality, the Equality Act, you know, everybody's like, equal pay, equal work, we're equal. The Bible already said that a long time ago. The human secularists, you know, at the Golden Globes and what have you, they're already fighting for something that's already in God's word. Okay, look, he said, "For ye are all the children of God by faith in Christ Jesus." So we're not all the children of God, only those who have faith in Christ Jesus, Messiah, Yeshua. So people will say, well, how do you get faith? I want to believe, but I can't. Well, then I would say, pray and ask God if he's real to reveal himself to you. And I would say, ask him for faith, because the Bible says faith is a gift. And also it says faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. So read the Bible and you will probably start believing in Christ, Messiah, Jesus. And then it says, there is neither Jew nor Greek, there is neither slave nor free, there is neither male nor female. We are all one in Christ Jesus. So there, the Bible already said a long time ago, you're all equal. And John 3:16 says God is no respecter of persons. That's a Bible verse. And John 3:16 says, for God so loved the world. That's every individual, every miracle that he created, every individual. For God so loved the world that not a people group, an individual, that he gave his only begotten son, Jesus, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. So the Bible already says, like thousands of years ago, that we are all equal. We are all equally loved in God's eyes, and that he died for each one of us individually. So that's why the people who don't believe in the Bible, they're just reiterating what it already says in different words, but they're ranting and raving for no reason, because we're equal. We're all equal. My friend showed me this video, and it's kind of awesome because the guy is telling facts. People get so emotional over political issues, but we should listen to facts once in a while. Anyway, I thought it was good.
The debate topic is, where is America going on racism and BLM? And what should we be doing next? And we're going to begin with Gay Town Hall and Taisha.
As someone who sits on this panel freely and with consent representing the black populace, as a black person, I find it really hard to have conversations and see these opinions from people who do not look like me and don't share that lens and that reality of that fear walking out the house and being troubled when I see a police officer down the street knowing that I could be racially profiled at any moment.
We're going to move to Walkaway. Who's going to begin for 2 minutes?
I will go.
Okay.
So I just want to start by saying that I may not look like you, Taisha, but I'm just going to give you some numbers, and numbers have no color. They don't lie. So why don't we start with the fact that there are 328 million people in America. There are 41.4 million black people in America, which is 12.6% of the population. Yet 12.6% of the population is committing more than 50% of violent crime in this country. 9 unarmed black men were killed by police in 2019. 9 unarmed. Now, unarmed doesn't mean innocent. Unarmed doesn't mean not a threat. So last year, 0.000022% of the black population was an unarmed black person killed by the police. That is why we are burning America to the ground. That is why we are creating this false narrative of black people being attacked by police based off of 0.000022% of the black population. This represents 0.1% of all black homicides in the entire year of 2019. A police officer is 18.5 times more likely to be killed by a black man than a black man is to be killed by a police officer. The number of unarmed black Americans killed by police is down 23% since 2015 when Barack Obama was the president. And 93% of black homicides are committed by other black Americans. So if you truly care about black lives, I suggest you get to Chicago, because every weekend dozens of black people are being killed by other black people. The Black Lives Matter movement is the greatest lie ever told, ever believed, and we are burning our country down for no reason whatsoever.
All right.